In the last video for this section, we're going to see how to linearize systems of difference equations. The procedure is very similar to that for differential equations, only with a few slight differences. So our example problem is we're going to get x1 and x2 today are functions of x1 and x2 yesterday, and they're nonlinear. It's x2 cosine of x1 x2 minus 1 and e to the x1 x2 minus 1. Or more we'll express this in vector form. X today is f of x yesterday. And our function has two pieces. F1 is x2 cosine x1 x2 minus 1. And f2 is e to the x1 x2 minus 1. OK. Now you'll notice that 1 is a fixed point. A fixed point is a place where f of a equals a. If yesterday x1 and x2 were 1, then today x1 will be 1 times cosine of 1 times 1 minus 1, that's cosine of 0. So 1 cosine of 0 is 1, and e to the 1 times 1 minus 1 is 1. So if we start off at 1, 1, we stay at 1, 1. As usual, we ask the question of what happens if we start off close to a fixed point? So, as always, we concentrate on the difference between where we are and the fixed point. The deviation is what's going to be linear. And we say y of n is x of n minus a, which is f of xn minus 1, because that's what the equations say, minus a. And that's f of xn minus 1 minus f of a, because f of a was equal to a. That was the definition of the fixed point. And that's approximately the derivative of f, that's the matrix, times x of n minus 1 minus a. In other words, it's a times y of n minus 1, where a is the matrix of partial derivatives evaluated at x equals a. Okay, so we have our linearized equations are that y today is a times y yesterday. And we solve them by diagonalization. In particular, our solution is going to look like a combination of powers of lambda times the eigenvectors. And we have stable modes when the eigenvalues has size less than 1, neutral when the eigenvalue has size 1, and unstable when the eigenvalue has size bigger than 1. So let's do that, our particular example with the cosine and the exponentials. So our first function was x2 cosine x1 x2 minus 1. Takes a derivative with respect to x1, and you get minus x2 squared sine of x1 x2 minus 1. Derivative with respect to x2 has, by the product rule, it's cosine plus x2 times the derivative of the cosine, so that's minus x1 x2 times the sine. And f2 was e to the x1, x2 minus 1. And take partials with respect to x1 and x2. And there's the answers. So now we want to see what happens when x1 and x2 are 1. So 1 times the cosine of, negative 1 squared times the sine of 0, that's 0. Cosine of 0, that's 1. Minus 1 squared times the sine of 0, that's 1 minus 0. Here we have 1 e to the 0, and here we have 1 e to the 0. Put it all together, and our matrix is 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay, we find the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors. The eigenvalues are 1 plus or minus root 5 over 2. 1 is the golden mean. It's often written with the Greek letter phi. And the eigenvector is 1 phi. And this is unstable, because this number is bigger than 1. You take higher and higher and higher powers of it, and you get bigger and bigger and bigger things. The second eigenvalue is 1 minus root 5 over 2. Here's the eigenvector. This number is less than 1. It's about negative 0.6. So you take powers of it, and it gets smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. So what you discover is that near 1, 1, if you vary it in this direction, actually, I should probably draw a little bit to the side. It's not vertical, it's diagonal. If you vary in this direction, the direction of b1, it runs away. Changes in this direction get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. but changes in the direction of the second eigenvector get smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. One unstable mode, one stable mode, so overall the system is unstable. If you start off with just some general point over here, it's going to run away like that. And I draw it as a continuous thing, but really it's you start here, then you go here, then you go here, then you go here, then you go here. Okay, that's the example.